Continuing on the subject of ceremony, can you share what are some of the core ceremonies that are practiced by contemporary Ohlone people who are involved in ceremonial ways? And I'm curious if those ceremonies are mostly rooted in historic Ohlone culture, if they're sometimes shared from other indigenous peoples or received in a fresh new way from spirit, and just a little bit about that process. So,
in terms of today's ceremony, I would say for sure some of it is borrowed. But in my teachings, what had happened was everybody knows, and it's pretty common understanding that traditional and ancient is practically non-existent. But what it is, it's a revitalization of a culture and a language and a way of living. And so what happens in terms of ceremony is, just like the villages that once were part of this whole area, people shared. They shared stories, they shared ways of life, and they were just kind of common human gatherings and honorings that always took place, and we know that to be true. So branching off of that, a number of ceremonies were recreated for the Ohlone people. So some of them are created really based on a real foundation, and some are created based on our understanding and relationship with the environment that we live in and human need. So how can we recreate old ceremonies? The Berkeley Library has many, many cylinders, wax cylinders, of songs and recordings from Ohlone people in Ohlone language. And some of that has actually been transcribed. Some of it, and I have some, they're available in digital form, and some is translated. And with that foundation, we can recreate some of the things that used to happen. And that's really, really exciting. We are able to take from the older people that are gone, like gone since before the 1900s. We can take their words and bring them back to life. So that's really exciting. And if you can understand anything about the language, and again, you know, there's different ways to transcribe it. If you can understand any of it, then you have a little bit of guidance in terms of what in the world are you doing today, and what are you honoring today, and how are you honoring it, and what was important at that time, at the turn of the century. Again, we're talking about 1900. What was important at that time for them, and is there a chance to carry on their vision, their mission, their words of encouragement today? And so that's a big part of it. So what do we do today? Some of the honorings that I can talk about start with birth. So when a child is born, we may take the child to the ocean, which is where we came from. We may take the child to the ocean to introduce the child to ocean in a ceremonial way. And it's really incredible. You know, people may or may not believe in this particular ceremony, but what I've seen in children that I've taken to the ocean later on is they just, regardless of what their parents believe or how traditional the parents are or how busy the families are in maintaining ceremony for the child just has this real grasp for the environment on their own. I watch them play, I watch them talk, and they're so engaged with this relationship to nature. And, you know, I have to believe it's that first initiation and that introduction with ocean. So that's one of the first ones. Another one, which is pretty common and shared by many nations, is kind of a, it's a vision quest. And it's also a time for young women and young men to kind of find themselves. And so they are introduced to adulthood in that way through this kind of 4-day vision quest. And sometimes it happens all in 4 days in 1 year, depending on the child. And sometimes it's over a couple of years. You know, if the child can manage 1 day and that's enough, then 1 day is enough. The goal is that eventually, within a few years, they're able to do this vision quest within 4 days all at once. So that's kind of one of the rituals that takes place. There are also, I would just call it kind of marriage blessings. It's not exactly the marriage ceremony that we think of today, but marriage blessings that kind of go along with, you know, two people coming together and the beginning of their family life. So that's one of them. And there just seems to be a lot of ceremony, unfortunately, around first memorials when people pass, and then later on, after the memorial, is the crossing over ceremony. Those two are probably really the most important ceremonies for us right now, because we do them not only for people that we know physically, our own family members and friends, but we do them for the ancestors today, again and again and again. And that's probably the hardest part. And when I'm talking about the ancestors, I'm talking about people that lived in this area that were actually unearthed due to progress, due to the new development of sites, due to, you know, society's need to expand. They start to dig into the earth and they find the remains, human remains, of Native people. And so when the Ohlone people or any other Native people generally are involved or informed about that, there's a whole process of reentering the spirits and the belongings and the remains of a person's life back to where it came from.